Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the InData project at Easterseals Crossroads. Today we're going to be talking about Phrase Expande, a great way to be able to do text expansion in whatever app you'd like. So let's go take a look.
Hello, my name's Jim Rinehart. I'm an Assistive Technology Specialist here at Easterseals Crossroads. Today's tech tip is about the Phrase Expander app for Windows. Before you, this is the web page where you would go to download the Phrase Expander app. It's phraseexpander.com/download. Phrase Expander does offer you the option of a 21-day free trial, so you can try it out for yourself, see if you like it before you actually purchase it. So this is the app where we go. So let's take a look into it and see where we can do with it. So I'm going to task switch. I've got it open here. And this is the page which has the home tab and has right now some of the autocorrect features up. If I go to the download free autocorrects, which would you'd be doing the first time that you download, you get this list of downloads. Now, some of them I've already downloaded, and I'll point that out here in a minute. Some of them I would still need to download if I want them, such as things like misspellings in Dutch or misspellings in the UK or some of these other ones. But when I download them, they do show up over here on the left. And right now I have the misspelling, the English US misspellings in front of me. Now, it has many that download automatically, but what I just did, that TS you see at the top, is actually one I created. So how to create a new one, I do new autocorrect, I click on that. It opens up an edit box at the bottom, and I'll put PS there for potato soup. I hit the tab button key, and I can type in potato soup, and then press enter. Okay, so that puts it in our autocorrect, and what I can do with that is that I have a Word document open, so I'm going to switch to that. And I can type, I would like some, capital P, capital S, because that's what it did, and it puts in potato soup. Like that. So there we go in that regard. So I'm going to switch back here for a moment and show you some of the other features. It does do autocorrect, so if you mistype me, it's got all these lists of over 12,000 corrections it'll make for you along the way, but you can put your own in. The other things you can do with this is you can create new glossaries. And I've done a couple of those new ones down here at the bottom, like the music, and one for baseball, and it works the same way. So if I want to put a new autocorrect in for that, I go up and click on autocorrect, and maybe I type in STL, and that would be the St. Louis Cardinals. And then again, how this works, if I go back here and see STL and puts in St. Louis Cardinals, and the CR for Cincinnati Reds. And that's kind of, again, how this works. So I'm going to go back over here to this and show you really quick that if you want to put in a new glossary, you can click on new glossary. It puts a name down there. You have to put something in there. So let's call this food. And it creates a new glossary for, in this case, food. Right now is showing nothing is in it. And I could go and put new autocorrects in there for that. Another feature that this does have, it does have the download medical templates, which has some templates. If you are a medical person, it would be excellent for that. And again, this app is really, really excellent if you have challenges with typing, maybe either accuracy and or speed, and you wanted to create some shortcuts to where you could do a couple of keystrokes and type in longer words or phrases, that especially ones that you would use over and over again. There you have it. That is the Phrase Expander app for Windows. If you like it, give it a try, see how you like it. Again, you got that 21-day free trial before you have to make a purchase decision at all. So I thank you very much for tuning in today. Hope you have a great day and have a wonderful day on purpose.
Say thank you to the Indiana Telephone Relay Access Corporation for sponsoring our captions today. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easterseals Crossroads in Indiana.